Benin was once known as the Kingdom of Dahomey, a powerful kingdom in West Africa that flourished during the 18th and 19th centuries. Benin is home to the Venice of Africa. With around 20,000 residents, Ganvie is Africa's largest lake village, and it's a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Welcome to Wisdom of Africa, your weekly wisdom dosage. I am Karen, and in this video, I'll break down the meaning of 5 proverbs from Benin, the home of Grammy Award winner Angelique Kujo. Proverb number 1 from Benin says, when the mouse laughs at the cur, there is a hole nearby. The mouse is a small animal that is often seen as insignificant. While a cur is powerful and impressive, it's an impressive machine. But the proverb is a reminder for you to be humble and to be aware of your own weaknesses and opportunities so that we can find ways to succeed even in the face of powerful adversaries. For example, a small startup company might be able to out-corporate a very large and more established company by finding a niche, a very small niche in the market, and being more agile and adaptable. The startup company is like the small mouse, small, seemingly insignificant, but it's able to triumph over the large company, which represents the car, as in the big machine, by being aware of its weaknesses and its opportunities. And it brings us to proverb number 2 from Benin. How so true? And it says, there is no God like one's stomach. We must sacrifice to eat every day. The proverb, it emphasizes the importance of taking care of one's physical needs and that the need for food is a constant and important aspect of life that should not be ignored. Because food and nourishment is very essential for your survival and growth, and therefore, it should be prioritized. Of course, I understand there will be people that sometimes can't afford food or just can't find something to eat. However, that doesn't stop that God from wanting you to sacrifice. Your number one need will be to look for food and feed that hunger. I'll give you a fun fact from Benin. The practice of voodoo originates from Benin. Did you know that? Around 65% of the population believe in voodoo, and thousands of followers congregate in the seaside town of Uda to celebrate National Voodoo Day. Unlike Western understanding of voodoo, it has nothing, absolutely nothing to do with sticking pins into people through dolls, using dolls. It has nothing to do with it. It's all about making a positive impact on other people's lives through spiritual forces such as water, fire, earth, the wind. That said, there still are some animal sacrifices when voodoo is being practiced. And it brings us to my favorite proverb number 3. And it says, everyone has his place. Everyone. The dead in the cemetery and the living at the table. Everyone, everything, all things, everyone has a role to play in life. And it is important to focus on one's own responsibilities and duties. Focus on your role. The dead are in the cemetery and their role is to rest in peace. While the living, you have a role to play in this world. Focus on the present and the future. It's a reminder for everybody to live in the present and focus on your own role in this world rather than dwelling on the past or the fate of others. Yeah? Enjoy every moment. Take your responsibilities. You have your role. The living, you're at the table. You still have things to do. The dead, resting in peace. That time will come, but as for now, enjoy yourself. If you suffer from the fear of snakes, do you know what a fear of snakes is called? Ophidiophobia. Ah, English, eh? Why don't you have a word in Benin for the fear of snakes? Ophidiophobia. Yeah, you might want to skip visiting Benin. So if you're scared of them like me, yes, please do not visit Benin. If you cross paths with a snake, it's thought to be good luck. In fact, there's even a place called the Temple of Pythons. It's a home to a dozen of snakes that are knotted together in an indoor pit and they roam freely around the palace. Hey. Snake Palace. Ooh, I'm scared. And it brings us to proverb number 4. And it says, blacksmiths and woodworkers will never suffer from poverty. Seriously though, this is actually really, really true in the Western world. Blacksmiths and woodworkers can't suffer poverty. Their skill, just the ability. People who have a skill or a trade are less likely to suffer from poverty. You know why? Because they'll always be able to make a living. Always. No doubt. And it brings us to our last proverb from Benin, which is proverb number 5. And it says, we can only speak the truth when we turn off the light. How ironic, but true. Only in darkness is when the truth comes out. What does this mean? That honesty and integrity are important values, especially in difficult or trying situations. So in order to be truly honest and truthful, one must be willing to face difficult or uncomfortable truths rather than hide from them. For example, a leader facing a very difficult decision. They must turn off the light, in other words, be willing to face difficulty or uncomfortable truths in order to make an honest and truthful decision. They must be willing to speak the truth, even if it's hard or uncomfortable, rather than hiding from it. As the saying goes, knowledge without wisdom is like water in the sand. So if you like this video, I'm telling you, honest, you are going to love this one. This one, right here, right here, you're gonna love it.